you see, they are inside of the mirror container, they tones, and they give us absolutely beautiful meditation installation, but also looks like a discotheque image, mm-hmm. because light diode technology very useful for the publicity for the discotheque. And we have a feeling that inside of each both we see the hearts, and they are on the pulsation because we want the human contact. But around, turn the expression, connection lost. And everybody who uses the computer knows what is more awful things, what can happen when on the screen of your computer you see connection lost. We started to be dependent from the computer. We feel ourselves like an handicapped when connection lost. And in the same time, this feeling of the world connection, is it really connection or just illusion? Like in a big discotheque where 100 people go with the boot to be together, and in results everybody dance just with himself. So this beautiful installation, it's also the metaphors and also some strange feeling that this new reality, danger for us, this new reality can pose us a lot of questions and problems. So we feel, we have a feeling, because we also try related with the names and teams of the Biennale, to feel and to think together. Mm. So we have this feeling that something wrong probably will happen. And if our illusion and our hopes for new virtual reality, it's really the paradise, or it will be the new unfair. And we see the new installation, the installation last tries, doing by a group, IES plus F, and this is three-dimension animations. The story about children, adolescents, mm-hmm. who is the result of the pressing of the publicity and the glamour. Mm-hmm. They are very good dressed, they are in a very fashion movement.
Like Benetton,
they are really mannequins, yes. And this is children fashion. From the fashion agency. Ah. And this is the new reality. Absolutely, because what does it mean, the new reality? Our children now go, they want to go not to the ballet school, they want to go to the fashion agency. Yes. And what we have the robot, beautiful robot, but they know how to be closed, how to think, how to move, and they know that the struggle, this is the most important things, because the war, that it's one thing what they see through the computer games, and the children, they spend even now, today, more time with the computer, with these computer games where you need to kill men with their own parents, men with their own friends. So what will be this future generation? And the artist made their own version of the post-apocalypse, because each generation made their version of the paradise and the apocalypse. And this post-apocalypse show how these children made their struggle. We don't know the reasons why it's struggle. In the world, what it's combined by the pieces of the computer games environment. And this world started to be in an auto-destruction. But the children, they're still in life. They develop their war, their struggle, like the gods in Olympus in the Greek mythology. Because they didn't have blood, they didn't have the real contact, they didn't have the real dead. So if it's beauty, or is the awful future unfair, we don't know. Just the artist, with the music of Wagner, show us the whole new reality, but dealing and connected with the pieces, with the painting of Caravaggio, with
new
the
Baroque.
Old, with the old Greek mythology, with the Bible mythology, and we see the new reality, exactly, because we see how Christ was putting from the crest, we see the story of Narcissus, but they're still in life, they're non-mortal, and what it's mean, this new reality, where death doesn't exit, where blood doesn't exit, what looks like a computer screen, television screen, from what we saw the first war in Iraq, when we saw just the light, and we don't see the dead behind the screen, the destruction behind the screen. So the artist tell us, made attention, thinks, feel, and probably we can find the exit. And then we go out and we see on the front of our, on the, front of our pavilion, the project click, I hope, doing by the most younger participant of the 52nd Biennale of the Contemporary Art in Venice, Julie Milner. You see the instruction, click, I hope. This screen connected with all internet society. And in 50 language, we see like expression, I hope, moved on the screen. And people click. We don't know why they click. For what language they click. Normally they click for their own language or the language looks them common. And the language, this is the first signature of identity. Not nationality, not country, but exactly the language. And in each culture and in each language, it's exit expression, I hope. It's presentation of our wishes, it's presentation of our vital energy. And this is protection in the same time. And people click. And we see like the expression, give the answer, it started beyond the pulsation. And we see the local account. And we know how many people active in this language in just that moment. And we see the global account and we know how many people participate. In 3 days, what project opened, there are more than, I saw now, 209,000 people who participate. And this is the metaphors of our accumulation of hopes. And the world needs hopes. Our country, Russia, needs hopes. But everybody of us needs hopes.
Yes,
and
everybody.
I think that better if people will click hope than click kill.
Oh, yes. That's right.
So we click hopes.
Yes.